We are discussing about the auditing topic. The auditing topic, in that auditing topic, some of the main important in the first unit topic, some of the main important topics are to be discussing. Okay, in that one, that is what is the audit and what are the detection of the errors and frauds and prevention of errors and frauds. Auditor is a watchdog, is not a bloodhound, and misappropriation of goods, misappropriation of cash. Window dressing, and audit memorandum, functions of auditing, auditing depth. These are all the some of the main important important topics to discussing in the audit nature. Already we discussed it in the last class. Some of the what is the main important whistle mechanism, and some of the audit the different types of audits. And auditors, some frauds and any of the errors. We are going to discuss about the auditing concept. In that one, the word of audit is derived from the Latin word. Already we know about that. That is adire. Adire means the means is here means auditing is a verification of financial position disclosed by the balance sheet and sheet. The profit and loss account, the examination of accounts to ascertain whether the balance sheet is a profit or loss, accounts give a true or fair view of the financial position and profit and loss of the business. This is the meaning of definition, meaning and definition of auditing. What is the detection of errors and frauds? Detection of errors and frauds. Detention of errors and frauds means when the audit is to be completed or accountant completed all the entries and all the accounts are to be maintained, all the postings and ledgers, just like these are all will be prepared by the accountant, and afterwards the audit takes a place. When the audit takes a place, it will be main important for the auditing function to detention of errors and frauds and examination of the accounts. That is a main important audit function. In that one, this is the detection of errors and frauds means the auditor has to ensure that there is no material statements of the financial statements arising from errors and frauds. He has to exercise certain degree of skills and care for the detecting errors and frauds. This is the main important for the detection of errors and frauds. This can be accomplished through the checking and watching thoroughly books of accounts, ledger accounts, vouchers, and the relevant information data is available. When this data is available, the auditor they had to take the work on examination on the accounts of books of accounts. The auditor has a professional knowledge and expertise his own field to certify the financial statements as to their fairness and truth. He has decided degree of levels of checks and scrutiny to be applied the detection of errors and frauds. If he certify the accounts of accounts as correct or not, the best of his knowledge and belief, he can't be held responsible for an error or fraud which still there in a financial statements. Financial statements ku sambandhinchina mottham anni vaatini check cheyadam varaku maatrame auditor tana baadhyathanu nirvahistadu. Ala ante gaani akkada tappulaku annitiki kuda tappulu evaina jariginattaithe aa tappulaku auditor baadhyata vahinchadu. Kabatti ikkada em cheptunnamu ante auditing lo అతను ఎవరు ఆడిటర్ అనేవాడు ఖచ్చితంగా ఉన్న పుస్తకాలని అకౌంటెంట్ ఇచ్చిన పుస్తకాలన్నిటినీ చెక్ చేసి తప్పులను ఏవైనా ఒప్పులను సరిచేసి ఆ తప్పు ఒప్పులకు సంబంధించిన ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ని గ్యాదర్ చేసి ఫైనల్ గా ఒక ఆడిట్ చేసిన తర్వాత లెక్కలన్నీ కూడా చెక్ చేసినాము, అకౌంట్స్ అన్ని అకౌంట్స్ బుక్స్ అన్ని కూడా చెక్ చేసినాము, ఈ బుక్స్ లో ఈ తప్పులు ఉన్నాయి, ఈ బుక్స్ లో ఈ తప్పులు ఉన్నాయి అని రిపోర్ట్ ఇస్తూ దాన్ని సర్టిఫై చేయడము ఆడిటర్ యొక్క ముఖ్యమైన విధి అన్నమాట. అది దానికి సంబంధించిన పాయింటే ఇప్పుడు మనం డిస్కస్ చేసుకోండి. కాబట్టి ఏవైనా తప్పులు అన్నింటిని చూడడానికి డిటెక్షన్ చేయడానికి నియమించడం జరుగుతుంది కానీ బోర్డ్ ఆఫ్ డైరెక్టర్స్ కానీ రైట్. ద నెక్స్ట్ ఈజ్ దట్ ప్రివెన్షన్ ప్రివెన్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఎర్రర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రాడ్స్ ప్రివెన్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఎర్రర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రాడ్స్ ది ఆడిటర్ కెన్ డూ ఎనీథింగ్ డైరెక్ట్లీ టు ప్రివెంట్ ఎర్రర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రాడ్స్ ఆఫ్టర్ ద కంప్లీటింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద ఆడిట్ వర్క్ ఆడిటర్ కెన్ అడ్వైజ్ ద క్లయింట్ బై మేకింగ్ సజెషన్స్ రిగార్డింగ్ వేరియస్ వేస్ టు ప్రివెంట్ ఎర్రర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రాడ్స్ ఇన్ ఫ్యూచర్ ఇఫ్ హీ ఆస్క్ ఫర్ దట్ ద ఫైనలీ ఆఫ్టర్ ద డిటెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఎర్రర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రాడ్స్ బై ద ఆడిటర్ ద హ్యాడ్ టు గివ్ ద ప్రివెన్షన్ ఫర్ దట్ ఎర్రర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రాడ్స్ ఓకే వెన్ ద ప్రివెన్షన్ జస్ట్ ఇట్ విల్ బి గివ్ ద సమ్ సజెషన్స్ టు ద who's that client okay not to be give the activity or who the person ought to be give the any of doing of the audit audit plans they must be take give the some suggestions on behalf of the accounts to the client and the suggestions like that the changes in accounting system and improvement of internal control system in these features they give the suggestions to the client the chances of errors and frauds can be minimized if he advice is taken and implemented in right spirit these visits made by the auditor check accounts keep moral check and the staff engaged in preparing of the accounting books they know the accounts are finally to be audited and any fraud or error to be detected this is the main due to the suggestions that the suggestion will called as an prevention that is a topic on errors and frauds okay the next one is that next topic is that misappropriation of goods the misappropriation of goods means in a easy in case of any business which produces deals in goods and high value and highly bulky usually the businessman do not bother much of the deflection of the goods as compared to misappropriation of money the type of misappropriation is difficult to detect unless proper records are maintained and deflection of goods can be done by issuing of false credit notes the customer for the sales returns and such goods of misappropriated goods may be stolen by employees from the godowns is not to detect a misappropriation of goods only the efficient system of record keeping periodical checking internal check and adequate security arrangements will be helpful of avoid appropriation of goods this is the topic of misappropriation of goods means especially any deflection of the goods can be done by issuing of false credit notes to customers for sale returns and such goods are misappropriated goods may stolen by the employees from the godowns this is also it will become under the misappropriation of goods and the same manner misappropriation of cash the next topic misappropriation of cash means especially when the misappropriation of cash is usually done by theft or any cash receipt petty cash checks negotiable instruments showing a fictitious the payments of to workers creditors purchasers etc misappropriation of cash is very easy a person with a little effort or misappropriate cash particularly in large scale business where contact between the owners of business and the person handling cash is not very close particularly when a person is not subject to any form of check such person has a number of opportunities and methods of committing frauds but in small business the possibility which of the fraud remaining undetected is remote but which the increase in size of business the opportunities committing fraud also increase because the owners of the business have no direct control over the receipts and payments of cash. This is called as an misappropriation of cash. Okay, this is the topic for today. This topic in the small, this is the short answer questions in the auditing first unit. This is the topic for today. We will take the class day after tomorrow. Okay, thank you.